thought you can get it. Oh, baby girl, you're something different. I got you. Whatever, 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 whatever. Whatever you want, you can get it. Oh, baby girl, you're something different. I got you.
You the one that had me there from the jump. Pick me up when I'm down in the slum. Do a show, you be there in the front. Write it down, let it get high. You let no shots like bang, 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 bang. Yeah, true, you the one that I need. Never knew I could feel so complete. I'm a freak in the sheets all the time. I be making you eat tons with it in the middle light. Yeah, I love you, girl. I truly do. No second guessing in that. You my sugar, dugger, my snugger, new, my R.O.D. and all that. I do anything, plus so much more, cause I know you have my back. I ain't gon' lie, yeah, I got a real bad thing. Girl, you look good when you getting all mad. And when I'm stressed out, you dead. When I'm writing this song, you was sitting right here. Talk about you'll never leave, I love you so. That's the reason why you still right here. What you want, girl, yeah, I get it. When the ring and stay committed. When a house on the hill, when you wake up in the morning, you can see the view. When I'm on the road, I'm lonely, yeah, I always think of you. What you doing, what you wearing, have a night out with your crew. It's a party, so you out there paint the city. Spin around for me, baby, give me a kiss, you look so pretty, yeah.
Whatever, 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 whatever. Whatever you want, you can get it. Oh, baby girl, you're something different. I got you. Whatever, 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 whatever. Whatever you want, you can get it. Oh, baby girl, you're something different. I got you. Now if shit pop off, girl, you know I'm with it. And if you want it, girl, you know I spend it. And all these chickens, yeah, I know they hate it. But with all this cash, baby, can you blame them? Can you blame them? Girl, just worry about what we do. And that bitch, she just number two, number two. And no matter what girls I find, baby, they can never change my mind. Shorty, keep me out the streets, okay, I'm lying. But my baby hold me down, like all the time. And every time she come around, I'm like, damn, she fine. Find another girl like you, I couldn't even try. Fuck them other hoes, they can't fill your shoes. And girl, you know you fine. Maybe that's exactly why you're mine. Oh.
Whatever, 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 whatever. Whatever you want, you can get it. Oh, baby girl, you're something different. I got you. Whatever, 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 whatever. Whatever you want, you can get it. Baby girl, you're something different. I got you.
A lot of wrong, you know what I mean? But a lot of that shit, it just, I can't really explain it, you know what I mean? One thing I could do is just make it right next time. I hope you take me back the first time, I apologize for it. Let me talk to you.
Girl, yes. Let me wipe those tears from your eyes. Put your bags down, I know you feel the hurt inside. Cause I've been messing up and it seems that it's all the time. Having you wondering if I'm ever gonna do you right. But before you leave, please hear my plea. I don't wanna lose you, you that I need. I'm through with the games, can't let you get away. So girl, just listen to what I gotta say. Cause I know you're tired of going through the pain. Different women, things I do that got you tripping. I know you wishing that things will finally change. Cause you're sick and you're tired. No, this ain't right. This but I'm right. Don't wanna be while you crying no more. Girl, I'm trained.
walking out the door. So I'ma get my shit together, make things much, much better. Cause you deserve it and you worth it. So baby, I'ma change. Now you think you're doing the right thing. You say I don't appreciate you, girl, and I can't even lie, I know that I ain't right. And I be lying all the time. Before you say bye, please hear my cry. I don't wanna lose you, I need you in my life. I'm through with the games, can't let you get away. So girl, just listen to what I gotta say. Cause I know you're tired of going through the pain. Different women, things I do that got you tripping. I know you wishing that things will finally change. Cause you're sick and you're tired. No, this ain't right, this what I'm trying. Don't wanna be while you crying no more. Girl, I'm a train. Can't have you walking out the door. So, I'ma get my shit together, make things much, much better. Cause you deserve it and you're worth it. So baby, I'm trying to right this time for you. I know you're tired of going through the pain. The different women, things I do to get you tripping. I know you wishing that things will finally change. Cause you're sick and you're tired. No, this ain't right, this what I'm trying. Don't wanna be while you crying no more. Girl, I'm a train. Can't have you walking out the door. So, I'ma get my shit together, make things much, much better. Cause you deserve it and you're worth it. So baby, I'ma change. Oh yeah, I know you're tired, I know you're tired. I know you're tired of the pain. Oh yeah, I know you're tired of going through the pain. Oh yeah. What it is, what it is, what it is, what it is.
Picture radio show on FLOEmpireRadio.com. I want to thank you guys for tuning in today. We're going to have a very interesting show today. We're going to have Mr. Darrel Young come in the building. He has a movement called Get Right or Get Left. He's going to come in today with his team, and we're going to discuss some fitness tips, some diet tips. So if anybody want to call in, you can do that at 929-227-4646. He also is going to talk about his free boot camp that he's going to have this fall. So be prepared for that. You know, he's going to, you guys can call in if you have any questions about, you know, the kind of food that you're eating. You know, is it healthy? How can you be moderate? Because nobody's perfect when they're eating. You know, we all like fried chicken. We all like steak and ribs and all that kind of stuff, but you know, this guy's a professional young brother, and he's going to bring some professionals in today with him. And once a month, we're going to try to bring in like some health fitness gurus, people who can help us stay in the right direction, because you know, we're losing a lot of people at young ages due to health reasons. And a lot has to do with what we're eating and our workout habits. Are we working out enough? How many times a week we're working out? You know, how fit we're staying. You know, little things like taking the stairs instead of taking the elevator. You know, little things like that we want to be in tune to, so we could, you know, live a long life. You know, it's all about longevity. You know, taking a cab and you can just walk somewhere, taking a train where you can just walk somewhere. At the same time, you know, nice weather, you get to see some eye candy at that too. You know, so you know, they're gonna come in. But like I said, every month I'm gonna try to bring somebody in, and we're gonna talk about health one Friday out the month. You know, also today we're gonna have the American beatboxer. They're going to come in today, and they're going to display their talent. So, you know, I encourage people to call in today and, you know, ask questions. Let me know, you know, how you feel about the show. Last week we had young brother from Harlem, Cole Ice, come in, and he represented, you know, big time. You can catch his interview on BigPictureRadioShow.com, and you know he did his thing. So he'll be on the show again shortly, probably in a couple of weeks, and he's gonna you know let us know what he's doing, you know, his show dates, and let us know what's going on with the situation. Okay, so we played Backpack Shorty, I'ma Change, and he's gonna be on the show in October next month. So I'm definitely looking forward to seeing the young brother. He's from the South, so it's gonna be really good, you know, getting guests coming in from different states and kind of different vibe going on, you know. So I'm gonna touch a little bit on some rumor report news. I know some people like that. Mr. Freeway, artist Freeway from State Property, he has just been admitted to the hospital. He has a kidney failure, and he's in for dialysis. So prayers go up to the brother. You know, I hope he gets a speedy recovery, and you know, stay strong, brother. You know, we love you, man. Also, the game, West Coast General, he is coming out with the documentary 2. All right, part 2 to the documentaries. They're saying it's an all-star event featuring Kanye West, Drake, Dr. Dre, Kendrick Lamar, and more. So, I'm a big Game fan. You know, his first album, everybody know that first album's crack. You know, so I'm definitely looking forward to documentary 2. I know Dre is gonna, you know, show out on that with a couple of blessing him with a couple of beats. Somebody call in, let me know how. I didn't hear that the Compton album. I still didn't hear it. I was trying to download it a few weeks ago on Google Music, and the album wasn't even coming up. So somebody call in, let me know how that album is. And I heard from one person that was okay. You know, somebody call and let me know what it was about. 929-227-4646. Let me know. I'm also going to give a shout out to CJ Mills from Paterson, New Jersey. I'm going to give a shout out to Ski Casanova, young brother from Paterson, New Jersey. CJ's R&B artist. He was on the show a few weeks ago. He has a single on SoundCloud called Side. And this kid can sing. He got skills. You know, he'll be on the show again. And also the brother Ski Casanova. He also has some music on SoundCloud also. We actually, the first song I played was by Ski Casanova featuring CJ Mills. That was Got You. And I actually like that song. And I'm going to have to play it again during the show. I might, I don't know. You know, I try to stick to the list. I try to stick to order, you know. So, what else do we have in news today? Rumor report news. Let's see what we got here. We have, okay, Wendy Williams, her son. All right, her son was exposed to a drug called K2. It's a synthetic marijuana. I was going to talk about that a few weeks ago, but, you know, I don't know why I didn't. But I work at a hospital, and a lot of the patients, I work in a psych unit, and a lot of the patients they come in and they have taken that drug, K2. And it's a lot of brothers, you know, minorities, mainly minorities. And we need, it's first of all, it's 2% THC, and the rest is just a bunch of chemicals. Okay, so what they're saying is like it takes a total opposite reaction of weed. Okay, it mimics the reaction of weed. Okay, so the side effects, you know, the side effects are crazy. It's vomiting, agitation, hallucination, and death. Okay, they're saying 15 people have died this year from that. So I think, you know, if you out there, you know, I heard it's like a poppery or something like that. So if you're out there, then just please, like, just leave that drug alone. You know, I've even heard from professionals that it stops the oxygen from going to your brain. So if you're out there using that stuff, like, you know, I'm glad that Wendy Williams, she said that she sent her son to a what do they call it? She sent her son out of the country for a holistic treatment. Okay, so I'm glad that that her son is back to normal. You know, some parents give up on their children when things like this happen. The type of patients that I see when they take this, they come into the hospital and they are just, they can barely speak. They're very, like, agitated. They're very mad. A lot of them don't know their name. They mumbling, you know. So I don't know. And they're selling it in these bodegas, in the stores. And now, if the cops catch you selling it in the stores, it's like a big. Before it was just like a small fine. So the stores, they didn't care. But now it's even a bigger fine that the state is passing. Because now I guess it's touching home. You know, before it was just, you know, the people in the hood was doing it, you know, lower class was taking it. But now, you know, people, you know, you're gonna have politicians' children and nephews and nieces that are gonna come in contact with this kind of stuff. And what I mean, like, people think weed is bad, it changes people's personality. People will say that K2 mess is worse than crack. It's worse than crack. It's worse than cocaine. Okay, and you gotta keep your children on deck, right under you. Okay, know what they're doing. Know the friends that they're hanging out with. You know, I took my daughter to church last week, and you know, we go to Refuge Temple in Harlem, and a pastor was preaching. His name is Bishop Wilkins, good brother, and he said 80% of kids between 18 and like 24 feel that the Bible is irrelevant. So we're sitting down at the table eating, and my daughter said to her mother, she said, "Mom," she said, "did you know that 80% of kids between 18 and like 24, 25, they feel like the Bible is irrelevant?" And I was like, yes, like, my daughter, she's listening, she's getting it, you know. And I felt good, like, it makes me feel like, you know, it's going to make my job easier when they get older. You know, everybody's talking about, "Oh, did you get your gun? Did you get your 12 gauge? Like, did you get your Bible? Did you take your kids to church? Like, did you do anything with them? So when you get older, you don't have to use that 12 gauge. You might not even have to get a gun, you know? So, you know, a book is better than a well-built house, you know? So it's all about, you know, just being around your kids. I was just glad that she was listening, because, you know, sometimes you're in church and, you know, your kids, they fall asleep and stuff like that. And then you say, "You know what, you know, I fell asleep when I was little in church. As long as they here, as long as we here, then it's all good." But, you know, I looked over one time and I thought she was asleep, but she was actually up. But, you know, she was listening. So, you know, I have a younger year old. Well, she's 10, and I have a younger one. She's 7. And, you know, she's going to get it sooner or later, too. She's getting it. But yeah, back to the K2 situation. You know, it's a bad drug. You know, people stay away from it. It's not a good look. You know, like I said, parents, know who your kids are hanging around with. You know, I told my daughters, I said, "See, now that 80%, I said, now you're going to be in school, and it's going to be 90% of the kids doing one thing, and the other 10%, don't be part of the 10, don't be part of that 90% that's following the 89% or whatever. You know, be a part of the 10% that's saying, "You know what, that's not cool. I'm going to be part of the smaller group and do what's right." It's all right not to be part of the bigger group, of the majority. It's all right, you know. So it's good to really instill that in the kids, you know, and just keep it moving like that. It's changing these guys, and I see it every day. If I work with you, you know who I with. My coworkers are watching. Y'all can call in too, and you can vouch, and we can talk about that. I have no problem about that. You know, these people are coming in and they are getting medicated and they're being released, you know, and then they come right back, you know, 3-4 weeks later. And, you know, it's like, welcome home. You know, some of them have, you know, family problems, you know, the mother wasn't there, the father wasn't there, molested, raped, you know. But I try to say, hey, listen, don't let your negativity, don't let whatever happening in your life, don't let that define who you are as a person, okay? You have to use that, whatever happened in your life, use that as energy to do better in life. Don't just be, you know, going to a shell and be caged in. No, make something of yourself. Make something of yourself. You here, you survived it, you didn't roll over. That means you're strong. You know, so, you know, I even try to give some of the patients job referrals. Like, hey, listen, this place is hiring. You know, next time I see you in the street, I want to see you driving, you know, saying, hey, I'm just coming from a, you know, got my new car and this, that, and the third. Like, that's what I want to see. You know, I witnessed ex-patient of mine's throw a bottle at a lady in the street the other day. I'm going to get a cup of coffee early in the morning, and this woman throws a glass Snapple bottle at a woman, a pretty young woman at that too, and just hit her like boom right in her chest. And I just looked at her face, and she just looked at me. I looked at her, and she just started crying. And I said, and she had like a phone in her hand in a box. And I said, Miss, come with me right now. Let's go. You know, I took her to the ER department. I said, I work in the hospital. Let's go right here in the ER. You know, helped her out. You know, made sure she was fine. You know, I knew the patient's name and everything. I said, Miss, that was my patient. That she was in my unit. You know, and I said, this is her name. You can call her snitching if you want. You see what I'm saying? But this is her name, and you press charge and stuff. Because come to find out, she did that to two other people that same morning. Okay? So, another thing. If you're doing something that's right, that can save someone's life, okay, that's not snitching. That's called being smart. That's called being a hero. We need more heroes like that in this world, okay? But you know, so, you know, she's doing fine. She called me, and she said everything is fine. She thanked me and everything, and, you know, it's sad. It's sad, you know, and the sadder part about it is that one of the LPNs that I work with said that she was probably trying to get readmitted to the hospital, you know, to get that 3 square meal, you know, to get that everyday psychiatrist, it's almost like jail almost, you know, it's about to get cold. Maybe, you know, I don't know how long she thought she was going to be there, but, you know, you get a bed, you get 3 square meals, you get all type of activities and stuff. But they probably turned her down, said, you know what, no. You just did something. And she beat up a nurse at that. You know? So, my thing is that, like, they probably said, no, we're not letting you in. And she probably got mad and said, you know what? I'm going to take this madness out on people in the street. So, I don't know what she was smoking. Probably was K2. But, you know, keep your kids close. You know? I know every relationship isn't perfect. You know, you might not get along with the mother of your kids or the father of your kids, but sometimes you gotta look at the bigger picture. You gotta say to yourself, you know what, am I gonna let this, some people, they have those issues and they start, they take that out on drugs and liquor, you know, and at the end of the day, you're pushing yourself further away from your kids. You know, so now your kids really don't get to know who you are, because now you're running away from them. You're making up excuses, you know. So it's like, you got to stay focused. You got to stay focused. Focus on your kids. Focus on the big picture. Focus on, okay, you know, how can I be around my kids more? How can I help them? What kind of information can I give them? You know, and everything will be good. So, we're going to go to a break, and when we come back from our break, we're going to have Mr. Darrel Young and his crew come in, and we're going to talk about getting right or getting left, straight like that. Like I said, one Friday out of the month, we're going to get into some health and fitness talk, you know, because we want to get right, okay? So let's go into Cold Ice on Your Body, and then we're going to go into Cold Ice, Stay With Me, two of his singles, and we'll be right back, okay? Big picture.
Uh-uh. Rust out the chinks too. This shit sounds soulful, kid.
Ice, I think they gon' like this one.
Me too, kid. Let's go.
It's a million women who gon' want you.
That's facts.
But it's only one who's gonna love you.
Who that?
A bunch of niggas that's gon' want my body.
Let's
but
go.
Tell them, baby, no, baby, I'm sorry.
Woo.
All them other couples about to really hate us. Cause we curving everybody like we'll see you later. Baby, boy, you know it, I said ain't no answer for us. Baby, boy, I'm all on your body.
Girl, plus she dope in the face. I be all on your body, I ain't leaving no space. Know how many niggas hope they could get them a taste. Know how many wanna be the reason your nigga replaced. No talking to rats, no moving with snakes. Just flex like we should, let them see what they ain't. Different settings when we dine, it's dinner for steaks. From the Jets to the hills, it's bigger estates. Jeffrey Campbell your shoes, let you see how they feel. Threw the ring on your finger, let you know that it's real. Popped your first bottle of rose, let you see how it spill. Guarantee you this, you can bet that your nigga is trill.
It's only you and me who gon' want you. But it's only one who's gonna love you. A bunch of niggas that's gon' want my body. But I'm selling, baby, no, baby, I'm sorry. All the mother couples about to really hate us. Cause we curving everybody like we'll see you later. Baby, boy, you know it, us, it ain't no answer, promise. Baby, boy, I'm all on your body. I want your body.
You know they say, when you got that good girl, that's who you hold on to. Let me talk to y'all.
Woo! I know why they mad, cause we does this. People hating, but we love it. Rolex from the wrist, show them you stunting. Shoes all red at the bottom, baby, it's nothing. Hair long, face pretty, matching coupes. Race with me, makeup bag, cost $850. Me and you against the world as long as you stay with me. Your new coupe, I got that. I see your hair done, you got your top back. You claim you left cause I cheated, but it was not that. Licked your wrist, neck, and ring finger, you forgot that. But trust me, baby, I'm super good. All you did was everything I knew you would. Have any chick that I'm next to, you knew I could. Keep it real, soon as I cheated, baby, I knew I should. Shit got deeper, shorty start texting. I became eager, then we start sexing. You became weaker, tried to start flexing. Then you got fed up, and now we both exes. I know why they mad, cause we does this. People hating, but we love it. Rolex on your wrist, show them you stunting. Shoes all red at the bottom, baby, it's nothing. Hair long, face pretty, matching coupes. Race with me, makeup bag, cost $850. Me and you against the world as long as you stay with me. Perpetual, I'm talking Rolex. Saved a couple bands for that watch, you know the whole check. Tiffany for your ears, you know the whole set. I'ma work you out, and I ain't talking no Bowflex. No stress, I lit a good life. When you had to cry, I was who understood, right? If I could get you back, I swear to God that I would twice. All I tried to do was show you things that you would like. Iced out pendants, wristwear senseless. New coupe whipping, shoes Lou Christian. Jewelry store dipping, earrings glistening. End up misses, it's all that's missing. I know why they mad, cause we does this. People hating, but we love it. Rolex on your wrist, show them you stunting. Shoes all red at the bottom, baby, it's nothing. Hair long, face pretty, matching coupes. Race with me, makeup bag, cost $850. Me and you against the world as long as you stay with me.
I know why they mad, cause we does this. People hating, but we love it. Rolex on your wrist, show them you stunting. Shoes all red at the bottom, baby, it's nothing. Hair long, face pretty, matching coupes. Race with me, makeup bag, cost $850. Me and you against the world as long as you stay with me.
I know why they mad, cause we does this. People hating, but we love it. Rolex on your wrist, show them you stunting. Shoes all red at the bottom, baby, it's nothing. Hair long, face pretty, matching coupes. Race with me, makeup bag, cost $850. Me and you against the world as long as you stay with me.
heart, you can get it. Ooh, baby girl, you're something different. I gotcha. Whatever, 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 whatever. Whatever you want, you can get it. Ooh, baby girl, you're something different. I gotcha.
You the one that had me there from the jump. Pick me up when I'm daring in the slum. Do a show, you be daring in the front. Ride it down, let it get high. You let no shots like bang, 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 bang. Yeah, true, you the one that I need. Never knew I could feel so complete. I'm a freak in the sheets all the time. I be making you eat tons with it in the middle light. Yeah, I love you, girl, I truly do. No second guessing in that. You my sugar, dugger, my snugger, new, my R.O.D. and all that. I do anything, plus so much more, cause I know you have my back. I ain't gon' lie, yeah, I got a real bad thing. Girl, you look good when you getting all mad. And when I'm stressed out, you dead. When I'm writing this song, you was sitting right here. Talk about you'll never leave, I love you so. That's the reason why you still right here. What you want, girl, yeah, I get it. Want a ring and stay committed. Want a house on the hill. When you wake up in the morning, you can see the view. When I'm on the road, I'm lonely, yeah, I always think of you. What you doing, what you wearing. Have a night out with your crew. It's a party, it's a party. So you out there paint the city. Spin around for me, baby. Give me a kiss, you look so pretty, yeah.
Whatever, 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 whatever. Whatever you want, you can get it. Oh, baby girl, you're something different. I gotcha. Whatever, 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 whatever. Whatever you want, you can get it. Ooh, baby girl, you're something different. I gotcha. Now if shit pop off, girl, you know I'm with it. And if you want it, girl, you know I spend it. And all these chickens, yeah, I know they hate it. But with all this cash, baby, can you blame them? Can you blame them? Girl, just worry about what we do, what we do. And that bitch, she just number two, number two. And no matter what girls I find, baby, they can never change my mind. Shorty, keep me out the streets. Okay, I'm lying. But my baby hold me down, like all the time. And every time she come around, I'm like, damn, she fine. Find another girl like you, I couldn't even try. Fuck them other hoes, they can't fill your shoes. And girl, you know you fine. Baby, that's exactly why you're mine. Oh. Whatever, 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 whatever. Whatever you want, you can get it. Ooh, baby girl, you're something different. I gotcha. Whatever, 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 whatever. Whatever you want, you can get it. Ooh, baby girl, you're something different. I gotcha.
Good afternoon, people. Good afternoon. We're back. We're back. BigPictureRadio.com. Tune in. We're live. Live Ustream. You can also listen to us. Audio. BigPictureRadioShow.com. You can also call in 929-227-4646. And, you know, you can just call in. You can give a music request. You can ask questions. Or just give a shout out. Okay. So right now we in the building. We have Mr. Darrel Young and his team in the building. He's talking to the mic, brother.
Good job.
All right. You don't need the headphones. It's all good. Yeah, he's talking to the mic whenever you're about to, you know, talk. You know, so we got Darrel Young in the building. We have this movement here too. Get right or get left.
Taking the camera.
Get right or get left. They're in the building, and we want to thank them for coming in. You know, because, you know, we all want to live a long time, you know, and like I said, one Friday out of the month, I want to have a health and fitness situation where we have someone from the health field, the fitness field come in, and, you know, we can just ask questions, you can call in, and, you know, we can talk about, you know, the proper things to eat, you know, workout tips, things of that nature. So for our first Fitness Friday, we have Mr. Darrel Young in the building. And his movement, like I said, is called Get Right or Get Left. So, Mr. Darrel, thank you for coming in, man.
Thank you
for coming in, man. So, did you work out today? Okay. Will you work out today?
Yes, I'm gonna do some cardio.
Okay, cardio. Yeah, talking to the mic. Talking to the mic.
You hear me?
Yeah, because people they want to hear you, and this is valuable information that we're gonna be giving to the public. You know, before y'all came in, I was discussing the topic on K2. Wendy Williams, her son was exposed to it, and she had to send him out of the country for some holistic treatment. And I was also saying how, you know, I work at a hospital in a psych unit, so a lot of the patients that come in are using those drugs, you know. And one thing I learned from working out is that, you know, I try to get it in when I can. I'm a busy guy, you know, but it's like if you're smoking cigarettes, if you're drinking, you know, excessively, you're not gonna reach the potential, the level that you want to get to, you know, by smoking cigarettes and smoking whatever. Because, you know, if you're trying to do some good cardio, then you really can't go the length you want to go if you smoke cigarettes, because your breath is going to be shortened, you know. So that's one thing, you know, I learned, and that's one reason why I don't, you know, do those things. But okay, so we want to get into the business of it. When did you start taking muscle fitness seriously?
Man, I think it's been embedded since birth. Mm-hmm. My granddad, he was a bodybuilder, mm-hmm. into fitness, mm-hmm. so it kind of grew on me. When I was young, he used to come over early mornings, mm-hmm. and have me and my sister on like some straight militia in the living room, mm-hmm. get down, do your push-ups. Mm-hmm. So at an early age, I grasped it, really didn't understand the importance of it. Mm-hmm. And as I grew older, it mm-hmm. became more serious about it, mm-hmm. and dedicated to the lifestyle. But yeah, I think it started early, man. It was something I always wanted. I was always a slender guy, mm-hmm. always had abs. Mm-hmm. But, you know, like I said, as I grew older, I developed the strength and the muscle tone and everything else that comes with it.
Okay, so let's go around the table. And, fellas, I want y'all to introduce yourselves and just, you know, say your name and where you're from. All right? Let's start.
I'm Ronnie Hurricane Carter.
I'm from Uptown, live in Harlem, New York. Was raised in Queens. Mm. Boxing background. Been doing fitness for over 10 years now. Mm.
My name is Kareem Cantrell. I'm born and raised in the Bronx, but I live in Harlem. And I got a basketball background, but I got into the sport of this, you know, this physique/bodybuilding thing not too long ago, because I was inspired by the friends that's around me. But I always had the work effort as far as training and stuff, because I was always into sports, basketball primarily. But that's about it.
My name is Michael Howard, from New York, Manhattan. I'm nationally qualified men's physique competitor as well. I've always had a fitness background. I started off playing basketball as well. And as I got older and I saw that I wasn't going anywhere, competing was, it gave me the feeling of being in competition again that I got from basketball. So that's why I pursued it, and I also saw that I could help others while I do it as well. So that's why I do what I do.
Okay. All right. So Darrel, how many days a week do you work out?
Man, with these guys that's around me, mm-hmm. yeah, it's probably like 5 or 6 times a week.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's really no rest day.
So are they part of your the boot camp that you have?
Yeah, they're part of the boot camp, part of the movement. They're part of me, my mm-hmm. growth, my learning, mm-hmm. you know, my motivation. Mm-hmm. You know, I feel like to be a better person, you got to surround yourself with better people and mm-hmm. people that you can learn from all yeah. the time.
Yeah.
So got a strong circle here.
Okay. So we spoke before, and you said that you was into like the muscle competitions. Are you still doing that?
Yeah, actually, this guy Mike right here introduced it to me about a year ago.
Okay.
And it's addictive, you know what I'm saying? Like, okay. I got into it. I didn't do too well my first show. Mm-hmm. Kind of jumped out the window, got on a big stage. Mm-hmm. And, you know, like anything else. It was just experiencing and just learning about it and growing and knowing what you need for the next show and the next show and the next show just to win, you know, to place first place. So I actually did better on my next show, and then my next show is actually October 3rd, Brooklyn Grand Prix. I'm looking to do well.
Yeah.
Looking to do well in that physique competition.
Okay. All right. When did you start the boot camp?
Boot camp, actually, the guy that's sitting across from me, Kareem, me and him, we hosted through Harlem Children's Zone, Healthy Harlem organization, a nonprofit organization. We offered to the community. It's been about, how long have we been running? About nine
yeah,
almost
months.
A year.
Yeah.
Almost months. A year.
Okay.
And we've been booming, man. You know.
So the age range. What's the age range for the boot camp?
No age range. Yeah. 0 to 100.
Real quick. Awesome.
Yeah.
Wow. So you got people coming in with like their daughters, their sons, and
yeah,
making like a family situation.
Yeah, right. Get everybody involved. Right. So like how my story, I started out early. So the kids want to, you know, they're erratic and they want to know what's going on and what fitness is and how can you look the way I look. But, you know, you got to start at an early age.
Yeah, that's true. That's true, man. That's good, man. All right, so got a couple more questions for you, man. I wanted to know, do you ever like want to do like in any other boroughs, like Brooklyn, Queens? Like, do you want to expand it?
Oh, yeah.
Because I see you got a team with you, you know, so.
Man, we want to take over. We want to capitalize on everything. I feel like the energy we have, the innovation, the look, you know, we got everything. It's just about implementing and putting forth action. Ideally, I wanted to do a fitness tour, and like, you know, do the East Coast first, a couple of cities in the East Coast, a couple of cities on the West Coast.
Well, you know, the boot camps.
We host, you know, we go to these cities and we hit different demographics. We hit, you know, the low budget people. Mm. We go into the corporate world and do everything.
Sponsorship.
Everybody, yeah.
So endorsements, things of that nature.
Right.
Wow. Okay. All right. So let me ask you another question. I want to get into like the eating form, you know, because I know everybody, you know, we have issues with like with our diets,
right.
You know, and it's like people, you know, we like to work out, but diets are an issue, you know. So my question to you is, okay, when eating meals, is it important to have carbs or can you just eat the meats and vegetables? Because, you know, carbs, some people feel like that carbs
can be bloated, right?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, it depends on the individual. from my learnings, I understand that everybody body works differently. Everybody body mechanisms is different. Me, I'm a person with a fast metabolism. Mm-hmm. So, but I eat, everything is portion control. So I never like to eat to feel full. I eat just enough to sustain my hunger. Mm-hmm. And then you have some people who overeat, stretch their stomachs. Mm-hmm. And those are the people who really wind up gaining the excessive weight, the unwanted weight. Again, it's all on you, but you know, carbs, you definitely need them carbs though. Cause that's, I mean, you don't need the carbs because you can get energy from your veggies and fruits. But
not to interject though, carbs are important for muscle growth.
Yeah, feel free to kick in whenever y'all want to kick in.
Carbs are important for muscle growth. I wouldn't say they're a necessity because again, you have people that believe in a paleo diet, which is like a caveman diet. And so before you had to refine sugars and everything like bread and all that, cavemen didn't have those things. They survived off meats and vegetables, you know what I'm saying? And when you look back at that time, those guys were in hella shape. To be able to move rocks from wherever they moving them and however they do. So, like, again, I wouldn't say it's a necessity, but again, it is. You don't want to neglect that either. I mean, you just need to, I would say it's more about portion control.
Okay.
I mean,
carbs are an important source of energy. They do give you the energy that you may need throughout the day. Now, I think what Mike is trying to say is that you don't need a lot of carbs. You need just enough to give you the energy that you need. And you get that mostly from vegetables. Okay. So things like white rice, things like, you know, pasta and stuff like that. You don't really need those type of carbs. You know, those are the refined processed carbs. That's going to burn fast in your body and then make you tired at the end of the day. But vegetables, a great deal of vegetables provide, a large amount of carbs that is really all you need.
Yeah, because, you know, you go, like, to some of the West Indian restaurants, and you know, they give you all of this rice. It's like they don't want us to get healthy. You
Chinese
know,
food too.
Your Chinese food, but you know, it's like some of these restaurants.
Yeah, I always say this too. If you look, Chinese people eat a lot of rice, but you never really see a lot of fat Chinese people. No. You know what I'm saying? So
what do they do that we ain't? Is it the tea that they're
doing? Honestly, what they do, they don't eat the food that they sell us.
Yeah, I was about to say that.
But that's true. But they do eat the rice though.
They do.
They eat white rice. They big on white rice, but they eat a lot of seaweed, a lot of like vegetables, and a lot of soups.
I feel like they cutting corners because like you got a business, you know, you cater food or you serve food, more rice will fill people up. So you put more rice, less meat, less veggies, people eat it and they're full. They're like, man, I don't want no more. I'm good. Up. You know what I mean? Because rice can go a long way. You can stretch rice. So
it's cheap.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Growing up, my mom stretched rice. I had rice for dinner, wake up the next morning, rice and eggs. You know what I mean? So things like that, rice fill you up quickly. So I think it's all a mental thing.
I see it too much, man. Yeah. I take it personal, and I don't go back. You know, I'm like, dag, like you gave me all of this rice, but like two small pieces of meat. Excuse me, and then the meals be like $10-$12.
Yeah, right.
You know, so killing. I don't get that. So do y'all believe in cheat days?
Of course,
everybody has a cheat day. Yeah. Everybody deserves. If you work hard, you deserve a cheat day.
One day.
Yeah.
Why not?
We just eat anything you want to eat. Breakfast, lunch, dinner.
Nah, because you are what you eat, and it's definitely going to show.
All things in moderation.
Right.
Nah, I mean, from a competitive standpoint, like sometimes cheat meals are necessary because, again, your metabolism, sometimes it gets to a point where it won't go faster than what it is. And sometimes you need a cheat meal to kind of kick it in the gear.
Yeah.
Because your food is used to processing such that... A sustained way of eating every day. Mm-hmm. Like, so you're eating healthy, 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 healthy. Your metabolism is gonna stay straight at this point. So you need something to kick it in the gear. So like a burger sometimes, gotta take it to that next level to give it another kick. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So still moderation, but those that they are important.
Mm-hmm. Okay, all right. I got a little game. Oh, I'm sorry, we have a caller. Caller, go ahead.
Caller. Yes. Hi, this is Lisa in Texas. I have a question. I just had back surgery, and I'm going to be bedbound for a long time. So I'm curious, what should my diet consist of? Should I be cutting out carbs totally, or just having it maybe one meal a day? What do you guys suggest?
I would suggest minimizing your carbs, not cutting out totally, but if you're bedridden, definitely you want to eat a lot of protein. Get your carbs from vegetables. You don't necessarily need to eat pasta or rice or bread or anything like that. You can get all the carbs you need from vegetables. Just eat a variety of different vegetables.
Okay, go around,
okay.
I agree.
Wholeheartedly with that.
Yeah. Okay, so like maybe just have my eggs in the morning and my protein and vegetables for lunch. Protein, and then what snacks should I have during the day?
Like nuts, whole, like unsalted nuts, almonds,
fruits.
Fruits are very good. You can mix it up. You can have yogurt here and there. You can, it's so many different ways to do things and to like have a good diet to where it doesn't have to be so restricted.
I just don't want to gain any weight and lose muscle mass because I've been working so hard. And that's my concern, is that I'm going to start getting soft.
Well, how long are you bedridden for?
I've been bedridden now for 2 weeks. I probably have another 3 weeks to go.
About 5 weeks?
Yeah, about 5 weeks. I just had the surgery on Monday, so I'm starting to walk, you know, daily, but not really, you know, obviously I can't do anything, you know, major. So I'm just afraid that I'm going to start shriveling up.
You won't shrivel up. I mean, of course, you may lose some mass because, again, you're not exercising. You're just putting food in your body. But I think if you maintain a healthy diet, it won't be so hard to get back when you do get out of the bed, you know, and when you're back on your feet and able to exercise and do whatever it is you do every day.
I mean, lots of vegetables and protein.
Yeah, I mean, and two, I know we were just talking about minimizing carbs. Oatmeal is a great carb as well. So especially to start your day, like eggs and oatmeal is great. So you can definitely do
egg
that.
Egg whites or whole eggs?
I say egg whites.
Typically, when you do have carbs, it's okay to have carbs. I would suggest the best time to have carbs is for breakfast and maybe even lunch. You really don't want to eat it later on in the day. Yeah. So if you can have it before 12 or 1 o'clock in the day, that's pretty good because then you have the rest of the day to burn it off.
Right.
Okay. Okay. Thanks, guys. No Keep problem. Up the good work.
You're welcome.
Feel better. Thank you.
Alrighty, thank
you. Bye-bye. Yeah, so go and play a quick game real quick, Mr. Darrel, before we go into a quick break. All right? Yeah. I call this game right or left. Okay? So I'm gonna say a food name.
Alright.
I'm gonna say a food. And you know, you just say right for bad, right for good, left for bad. And you know, you could give a little substitution if it's bad. Okay?
Got it.
Whether wheat or brown, what have you. Okay?
All right.
So, donuts.
Left.
Left.
Yeah, say that loud.
whole wheat?
Whole wheat donuts?
Left.
Just because you hear whole wheat, you think it's good.
That, I'm going to say left, but if you ask me in the last week, I'm going to say right. But overall, left.
I mean, it's crazy, like, because they try to trick us, man. They trick us. You know, whole wheat glazed donut. Wheat. Are you serious? You know what I'm saying?
You got to be whole careful wheat, nowadays because they even trick us with organic and inorganic. You right. know, like mm-hmm. what's natural, what's you're talking you know, to fat free. They mm-hmm. they trick you with everything. So you really got to be careful and read the labels on what you eat nowadays
mm-hmm.
because not a lot of it is, you know, really good for you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right. Crunch berry cereal with almond milk.
Left.
Damn. Crunch berry cereals? Is that Captain Crunch?
Yeah.
Captain oh my Crunch. God! Oh, well. That's left. That's yeah. left.
Y'all see that's in my diet.
With the almond milk,
I had that this morning.
Strong
man.
Emphasis on the almond milk.
Almond milk is not good.
No, almond milk is great. Is
right. Oh, almond milk is good.
But you got
cereal. Right.
Yeah. I mean, cause I don't drink regular milk, so almond milk is good for me. All right, oatmeal.
Right.
Okay. Oatmeal, the flavored oatmeal.
Left.
What do you mean by flavored?
Instant
flavored oatmeal.
Left. I mean, because me personally, I love brown sugar. And I'll take the instant Quaker mm-hmm. brown sugar. I know that.
I would say it depends on your lifestyle. If you're training for anything in specific, you know, specifically.
Mm-hmm.
I eat instant oatmeal. It may not be the best for you, you know, but it's okay
for
breakfast because it tastes really good. But it's not that bad. It has okay. good, you know, good slow digestion carbs.
I substitute for the flavored oatmeal. I would suggest the peanut butter with your oatmeal if you need some type of flavor.
Oh, mix the peanut butter and oatmeal?
Yeah, but it's still a flavor yeah. and it's still you packing on lots of protein too.
Wow.
It tastes good.
It tastes
good. With the vanilla almond milk, it's great.
Mean.
Excellent.
Oh, peanut butter, mean. Almond milk, and oatmeal?
Mean. Yeah, man.
I'm mean to try the end.
Two mean. Scoops, Skippies. Boop, boop.
And you'll feel full. You'll feel like a tank.
And the oatmeal is high in protein, right?
Yeah.
Oatmeal is. You can do the steel cut oats.
Okay.
Those are the best way to go.
Steel cuts is good, but if you're not used to it, it probably tastes like disgusting the first time you try it. Like it's like you're chewing crumbs. But okay. once you get used to it, you'll be all right.
But see, steel cut oats, you only get that from like Whole Foods. You can't get that at Fine Fair and Pathmark, right?
Yeah, you may be able
to.
No,
I'm not sure. I know they have it at Whole Foods for sure.
Whole Foods, not your regular supermarket, though.
Yeah, we need more of those in the neighborhood, man. Steak.
Steak to the right.
Right.
Yeah, protein in it.
High on
good
protein.
Money. Fried chicken.
Love. Grilled
okay.
chicken.
Okay, what about you chicken. Know if you put it on a salad?
Love. You can put the baked chicken on the salad.
Baked chicken, okay.
A grilled chicken.
Okay.
Grilled chicken.
That's right then. That's right. Snapples.
Love.
Left. Too much.
Sugar.
Okay. Diet Snapples.
To the left.
Left.
Oh. Still a lot of sugar. Hidden sugars.
Damn. They're trying to kill us. All right. Seltzer water.
Right. Right.
Okay. Water. And then the last one, brown rice.
Right.
To the right.
I agree with the right.
To the right. Portion control right. still.
Okay.
Depending on your goals, if you look to lose or gain.
Okay. All right, so that was some good information there. That was some good information. So we're going to take a break. We're going to go into CJ Mills' side single. And we're going to go into Backpack Shorty Hold On. All right. This is Big Picture Radio. We got Mr. D Young in the building and the team.
Yo.
Get right or get left. Call in, people. 929-227-4646. If you have any questions, also get well to the lady who just called. Hope everything works out for you. Hope we helped you out. And y'all can check our website, bigpictureradioshow.com, where you can watch this show whenever you want to. And hopefully we'll have some of Mr. Young's t-shirts on our website. Right. Hopefully that'll happen.
Gotta get that going.
Yeah. And we're gonna make moves towards that, all right? So we'll be right back. We'll be right back, all right? Big picture.
I know you need it on the side. I can hit you from the side, girl. And we don't do this all the time. But when we do, you know you're mine, girl. Whenever he ain't acting right, you know I can get you right. Hey, now I done met 100 girls like you. The kind that got that cake and 182. Hey, now I ain't tryna put you on no diet. I'm just trying to chill, keep it quiet. Cause it ain't about me, it's about needs. Hit me on the phone, tell me where you want me. Take away your stress, girl, leave it in the sheets. You a good girl, but with me you were free. So, whenever things just ain't working, remember, what he don't know won't hurt him. I know you need it on the side. I can hit you from the side, girl. And we don't do this all the time. But when we do, you know you're my girl. My girl. Whenever he ain't acting right, you know I can get you right. Yeah, you can take a sick day from work just so you can come get this work. Hey, your girls know what to say when he call, yeah. You ain't gotta worry at all. Cause it ain't about me, it's about needs. Hit me on the phone, tell me where you want me. Take away your stress, girl, leave it in the sheets. You a good girl, but with me you were free. So, whenever things just ain't working, remember, what he don't know won't hurt him. I know you need it on the side. I can hit you from the side, girl. And we don't do this all the time. But when we do, you know you're my girl. My girl. Whenever he ain't acting right, you know I can get you right. Nah, if you're flipping out when you get home, you could just call me. Meet up, eat it up, beat it up. Tell your friends how I drive you crazy. Whatever he want, I will do. Yeah. Keep it between me and you. I know you need it on the side. I can hit you from the side, girl. And we don't do this all the time. But when we do, you know you're my girl. My girl. Whenever he ain't acting right, you know I can get you right.
So please do song. Somebody help me hold on. Hold on. Tell me hold on. When I try to do what's right, I end up doing wrong. So I'm finna let my soul bleed through the song. Somebody help me hold on. Hold on. Just help me hold on. Hold on. I'm taking shots to the Ciroc, blowing on the strobe. When I'm calling out for help, no one answers the phone. Somebody help me hold on. Hold on, just help me hold on. Start real music, hold on. Okay, I'm looking in the mirror, I see me, see me. I put my head down in disgrace, thinking what I could be. If I just would've went to school and stayed out the streets. But I was trying to provide, my daughter had to eat. Dropped to my knees and prayed to God and told him come for me. It ain't no showing love when they trying to take my plate from me. My closest friends, I never knew that they would change on me. So mama told me stunt on niggas when they hate on me. Hey, real shit, I could've been dead before. They put that pistol to my head before. The nigga shot me in my leg before. Sent me on the killing spree, it's what they begging for. But I'm just trying to live my life until I'm dead and gone. When I try to do what's right, I end up doing wrong. So I'm finna let my soul bleed through the song.
Somebody help me hold on.
Tryna hold on, man.
Hold on. Just help me hold on.
And time get hard,
hold
man.
Hold on. I'm taking shots to the Ciroc, blowing on the strong.
So I just
when
sit
I'm
back.
Calling out for help, no one answers the phone. Somebody
try
help
to get
me
my
hold
shit
on.
Together, man.
Hold on, just help me hold on.
Verse two,
on,
man.
Hold on.
Okay, I shed so many tears, thinking about the years of shit I went through. I'm just so happy to be here. I had so many friends, but most of them just disappeared. Trying to show me sympathy, you don't know how I feel. I get that work off on the block, serving all the fiends. My mom was sick, she didn't have a chance to chase her dreams. I had to grow up fast, she died when I was 14. My grandma took me in and told me she'd be here for me. So I took my at school and did what I had to do. Grandma told me to clean, I did it with attitudes. So when my birthday came, she showed no gratitude. She told me get it together, the devil's after you. Nobody
when
is bad as you.
Right, no. Doing wrong. So I'm finna let my soul bleed through the song. Somebody help me hold on.
I just sit back, man.
Hold on. Just help me hold on.
Take a shot of that Ciroc,
hold on.
Bro.
I'm taking shots of the Ciroc, blowing on the strong. When I'm calling out for help, no one answers the phone. Somebody help me hold on. Hold on.
Be happy, lost, man. Don't fake it.
Hold on. I told that pistol lad, baby, cut these niggas foul.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to have protection for my family child. So if you touch one of them niggas, you gon' see me wild. I was born to be a leader, I don't follow crowds.
No.
Calling out for help, but nobody answers the phone.
They don't.
All I wanna do is right, but end up doing wrong. Learning from my own mistakes, so I'm just moving on.
Woo.
I'm grinding every which way, so shit, I'm never home.
Never home.
I get that money, cut these bills, dude.
Bill,
cross me wrong, boy, I will kill. You. I can stop some niggas' meals too.
I
the government.
Okay,
the
okay, we back. We back. Big Picture Radio. You just heard Backpack Shorty Hold On. Back in the building. Monte Carlo, your host. We got D Mac in the building with his team. Get right or get left. We have a caller?
Yeah, you have a caller.
Yeah, go ahead.
I'm trying to find out what inspired you to come up with that name, D Mac.
What inspired me
get
to come
right
up?
Before you get left.
Come again?
What inspired you to come up with the name?
Well, get right or get left?
Yeah.
Okay. That's a good question. I don't know. Growing up, like my mom used to always say, because I got a younger sibling and she's definitely advancing and doing her thing. My mom used to be like, boy, don't get left. Don't get left behind and let your sister catch up, you know what I mean? Catch up above you or whatever, go past you, surpass you or whatever. So, I don't know, one day I was listening to something and it just struck in my head to get on the right track of life, the right track in fitness, the right track in everything. And I don't want to be that guy that's left behind that my mom's was talking about when I was growing up. You know, the shoulda, woulda, coulda of God. So just getting on the right path, the right direction in life. So get right before you get left. Nobody like to get left.
Mm. Oh, that's what's up. I just want to know because I want to reach out to you because I would like to. I heard about your program, your 10-week or 8-week program.
Okay.
What's going on with that?
Yeah, I mean, it's something I designed, you know, just working on something in the house. And it's designed for people who want to lose weight, tone, you know, tone, tighten, and build strength. I mean, I think I put it up on Facebook. But if you want, you can email me at alwaysright_88@yahoo.com and I'll shoot the 10-week program to you.
All right, cool. I'm gonna email you, most definitely.
Appreciate it, brother.
Cool. Thanks for tuning in.
Doing something great.
Appreciate it, man.
All right.
Cool. Thanks for tuning in, brother. Keep tuning in. 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. every Friday. BigPictureRadioShow.com. All right, so like I said, you know, we have Mr. Darrel Young in the building. People call in 929-227-4646, and you know we're discussing muscle fitness, health fitness. You know, okay, we have another caller. Go ahead.
Yes, hello. My name's Luis. I'm calling from Charlotte, North Carolina, and I had a quick question, Mac. What's the best way to stay motivated?
Man, first of all, you got to find out who you are and what you represent, and just knowing the importance of feeling better, looking better, staying healthy, longevity in life. You just gotta, you be yourself, your own motivation. It's self-empowerment, man. Like, I can't tell you, I'm my own my own motivation, but my family motivates me the most, because I know it's a lot of people who are in predicaments that kind of puts them at a halt from not exercising. You got some people who are paralyzed in wheelchairs and can't do what they do. So you should just see the bigger picture. You know what I mean? There's always somebody dealing with something or going through something differently than your struggle or whatever. So just think outside and look outside the bubble and just get it, man, every day. You just got to grind.
Thank you, Mac. Thank you, Mac, so much. And Charlie, North Carolina loves you. Jay Wu loves you.
Appreciate it.
Wow.
Best of the Kappa Sigs.
Wow. Thanks for tuning in, sir. Wow. So people, man, they want to know. They want to know what motivates you, you know, so they can stay motivated.
Yeah.
You know, got injuries. Some people get injuries, and that kind of, like, you know, keeps them back from working out. You know, they sit on a couch. You know, they eat whatever they want to eat. And
right.
They gain so much weight. You know, so I think it's really important that people, they know the types of food to eat when they do get injured. God forbid they get injured.
True.
I think what keeps a person motivated or what keeps me motivated is just having a vision and knowing where you want to go. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Sometimes when you don't know where you want to go, mm-hmm. it's hard to be motivated because you're just doing it just to do it.
Yeah.
But when you got an end result or an end goal, mm-hmm. you know you got to get there. And always ask yourself when you wake up in the morning, why did I start? Mm-hmm. Like, why did I say I was gonna go to the gym? Why do I want to look better? Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And if you keep that at the forefront of your mind, you can't stop.
True.
You understand?
And not
to cut you. And one thing, people use it for the wrong reason, but Instagram could be motivation. Mm-hmm. And I say that because I started competing, and I wasn't really sure if I was gonna compete, but I used to post it on Instagram, mm-hmm. and people was watching. And I started to feel like, yo, I can't stop. Like, I got people seeing what I'm doing. Like, and
right.
I'm gonna look like a failure if I stop.
It's almost like a job.
You know what I mean? So it kind of was like, it kept me like, oh yeah, Mike, you gotta go. Cause they're gonna be like, are you slacking if you don't go? Mm-hmm. So I stay motivated that way. Mm-hmm. So you can use anything, really.
Wow. What was you gonna say?
One of my biggest inspirations, pioneer person I look up to, my cousin David West. He suffered an ACL injury. Like maybe 2 or 3 years ago, mm-hmm. right? And this is a man who is determined, and when he speaks, everybody's just like quiet because, you know, it's wisdom, straight wisdom coming out of his mouth. So he suffered that injury, and he was scared to dunk and to be explosive again. But I watched him like just go hard, train with him one summer. He was going through the rehab and, you know, all the psychological problems of not jumping off the floor and coming down on that knee again. Mm-hmm. But it's just something you got to tell yourself. You know what I mean? This is the life you're going to live. You know, you're going to continue to let that injury defeat you, or you're going to, you know, get past it and be better, be stronger, grow bigger. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Because, I mean, when you break bone, don't bone grow back 2 times stronger? Okay. So it's just that. That's what I think. When you break bone, it grows back 2 times stronger. So, I mean, you can't dwell on that. Like, family got to eat. You got to keep it going. That's the end of your career? Nah, you're going to go through this rehab and we're going to get better. You may add something to your game, you know,
and also,
jump shot.
Like you said, just educate yourself on people that are successful, mm-hmm. and see that nothing came overnight.
Right.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Bill Gates is not rich because he woke up one day and was rich, you know?
Process.
Yeah, you know what I mean? And there was a lot of falls in that process. Okay. Now, he probably fell 100 times before he got to where he wanted to go. Just like I was telling him earlier, I watched The Pursuit of Happiness. That man lost his wife, lost his job, sleeping in the bathroom in the train station. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And went and made $1 million, made his own company. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So you got to educate yourself on people like that and understand that anything you want is not overnight. It's not an overnight success. These people work hard. And if you want to make your brand successful, you want to be successful, whether it's in the gym, at your job, you just got to work and do whatever you got to do to be successful.
Yeah.
Ain't that?
Yeah, we have a caller. Sorry. You go ahead, caller. Hello, caller. All right, Kareem.
Yeah. I was going to piggyback on what Mike said. I just respect that nothing is never really given to you in life. Like, everything takes hard work, you know? Like you said, nothing, like Bill Gates wasn't rich overnight. So, like, for me, like, I feel like I represent the Harlem Shooter Zone, right? And the kids motivate me. Like, I wasn't born and I didn't wake up and say I was gonna become a fitness specialist or somebody who took fitness seriously. I idolized Jordan. So my main concern was trying to get a D1 scholarship, this and that. Things didn't work out. So I took it another route. And I felt like being around good people and just the friends that I have now, mm-hmm.
and people that gave me advice in the past, like, it led me to a different route. Like, and I feel like working out and being in shape and inspiring other people, like, gave me life. Like, I have a younger brother that looks up to me, you know, and he's like one of the, you know, my biggest, you know, critiques. Like, he critiques me on everything. Like, yo, bro, you gotta do this, you gotta look like this. But he's always on top of me because he knows that, you know, I have what it takes to become, you know, the best, you know. And I'm very competitive, so if I do decide to compete next year, being amongst these guys, and I know I gotta work twice as hard, like, but I work out with them so much that I feel like I am competing. And, you know, that's all I do, man. I surround myself around people that's either doing better than me or is trying to go the same way, in the same direction that I'm trying to get to.
All right, cool. So all you guys professional trainers?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. All right. So can we just go around the table? We're going to start with you, Darrel. Just give the world your information, like your Instagram or your email. So if they want a personal trainer, they want to book you, you know how they can get in contact with you.
Hey, what's up, y'all? My Instagram name is Get Right Workouts. Facebook is Darrel Young. I have an email address at alwaysright_88@yahoo.com. Shoot, call me up personally, 917-488-1039. That's how I'm giving it up. If you want to get right, there's only one way to get right. And hit me.
My name is Michael Howard. On Instagram, I'm MH Physique. Facebook, Michael Howard as well. I'm not giving y'all my number, but you can definitely reach out to me. Email mhphysique@gmail.com. Yeah, just feel free to ask any questions.
How you doing? My name is Kareem Cantrell. Instagram is Reem the Godson. Okay. I conduct a boot camp Mondays and Wednesday night uptown, 144th, between 7th and 8th Avenue, from 7 to 8 p.m. So you guys can lock in there, or you guys can email me at remo8721@yahoo.com.
All right, one second. We got a caller? Go ahead. Caller? All right, go ahead. My bad.
My name is Rodney Hurricane Carter, boxing specialist. All right, you can reach me at Hurricane Carter Jr. on Instagram or Hurricane Fitness on Facebook. I train in Harlem out of the Fit Lab, so definitely feel free to holler if you want to learn how to fight, how to defend yourself, mm-hmm. how to just be more confident in general.
Awesome. So we got a caller though? Okay. All right, so people call in if you can before these young brothers leave, because they're giving us so much knowledge, you know, on how to get right, because none of us want to get left, okay?
Fact indeed.
You know, ready.
None of us want to get left. You have the information. You have the emails. You have, you know, we're going to try to get these guys in, you know, whenever they can in the future. You know, because we all want to be around a long time and we want to look good. All right, so we're gonna go to break. All right, this is Monte Carlo, Big Picture Radio Show. We got the Get Right or Get Left movement in the building. You can go to our website maybe in a few weeks, and we're gonna try to get his t-shirts, the Get Right or Get Left t-shirts, on our site. That way, you know, y'all can get down with the movement. All right, and we're gonna put his information. The show is also gonna be on our site, BigPictureRadioShow.com. So you'll be able to watch the show tonight and, you know, get the information again if you missed it, all right? All right, we got a caller. Go ahead. Caller? All right. Oh. Okay. All right, so like I said, you can watch the show later on, BigPictureRadioShow.com on the website. And you'll get the information again. That way, if you want a professional, you want some training, you want to get right, you want to get your abs together, you know, these brothers, they're going to help you, you know, go into the right direction. Okay? So we're going to take a break, and we'll be right back. All right? BigPictureRadioShow.com, FLOEmpireRadio.com. We're going to go into Jason Derulo featuring Backpack Shorty. No apologies. All right? 100.
This mess we in, not another argument, baby, baby.
playing sorries. We don't have the guts to leave. Crazy, crazy. And even your tattoo, it can be removed. Baby, it's all good. Baby, it's all good. You cut the deepest, but I'll stop the bleeding. Baby, it's all good. With no regrets and no apologies. No apologies. Stole a second ways. No apologies and no apologies. No apologies. Stole a second ways. No apologies.
Hey, send our baby girl was headed. Claiming you ain't worried about chicken smashing. But every time you not with me, you be acting. With your homegirls started laughing. Talk about mashing. Say this a pill, baby, show me some magic. Be gone, cause I ain't even worried about you, baby, leave me alone. Hacking like you fly when you never even flown. It's about a million women wanna right my wrong. Carolina, I'm home, but they know that I'm fly. That's probably why they bug me, give me neck like a title right. Fuck you and I, but I'm tired of being tired. And don't go calling my phone, baby, you tell her why.
low, you be there in the front. Ride or die, let it get high. You let no shots like bang, 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 bang. Yeah, true, you the one that I need. Never knew I could feel so complete. I'm a freak in the sheets all the time. I be making you eat tons with it in the middle light. Yeah, I love you, girl, I truly do. No second guessing in that. You my sugar dug, my snugger new, my R.O.D. and all that. I do anything plus so much more, cause I know you have my back. I ain't gon' lie, yeah, I got a real bad thing. Girl, you look good when you getting all mad. And when I'm stressed out, you dead. When I'm writing this song, keep a sin right here. Talk about you'll never leave, I love you so. That's the reason why you still right here. What you want, girl, yeah, I get it. Want a ring and stay committed. Want a house on the hill. When you wake up in the morning, you can see the view. When I'm on the road, I'm lonely, yeah, I always think of you. What you doing, what you wearing. Have a night out with your crew. It's a party, it's a party. So you out there paint the city. Spin around for me, baby. Give me a kiss, you look so pretty, yeah.
Whatever you want, you can get it. Oh, baby girl, you're something different. I gotcha. Whatever you want, you can get it. Oh, baby girl, you're something different. I gotcha. Now if shit pop off, girl, you know I'm with it. And if you want it, girl, you know I spend it. And all these chickens, yeah, I know they hate it. But with all this cash, baby, can you blame them? Can you blame them? Girl, just worry about what we do, what we do. And that bitch, she just number two, number two. And no matter what girls I find, baby, they can never change my mind. Shorty, keep me out the streets, okay, I'm lying. But my baby hold me down, like all the time. And every time she come around, I'm like, damn, she fine. Find another girl like you, I couldn't even try. Fuck them other hoes, they can't fill your shoes. And girl, you know you fine. Baby, that's exactly why you're mine. Oh. Something different, I gotcha. Whatever you want, you can get it. Ooh, baby girl, you're something different, I gotcha.
Ooh, baby girl, okay, we're back. Monte Carlo, your host. You're watching the Big Picture Radio Show.com. We have our brother Craig, 100 in the building. We have Mr. Chesney Snow.
Yo, what's up?
Yeah. All right, Chesney Snow, he's representing the American Beatbox documentary, right?
Yeah, it's called American Beatboxer. It's a feature-length documentary about the art of beatboxing. Me and my partners, Tim Fisher's here. He's supposed to be here. He may swing in at some moment. He's one of the associate producers. My man Rich McEwen is a co-executive producer with me, and Manavaskar Kublal directed it. And we with Tim and the team, Sean, the whole team, man. I'm really thankful that they came on board for this. I started this event as a live competition, but I knew that we were doing something historical, and I knew it was very important to document it. So I didn't know exactly what story we were going to get, but I knew that I didn't want the story of American beatboxing to be rewritten, because as hip hop had kind of forgotten about beatboxing, it's just like every other element of hip hop, it spread throughout the world. And then became larger overseas than people could ever imagine. I mean, a beatboxer opened up the Olympics. You know, they've had beatboxing battles going on in Germany. You have a beatboxer signed to William Morris, as a beatboxer, you know. And this, these sorts of things were happening over in Europe. And as that was happening, the art form, because it's more of an instrument, is as opposed to just a genre, it really became disassociated with hip hop in the language, but in all the aesthetics, you know, the way the kids were like wearing their clothes, the way they were speaking, you know, the monikers that they took on was very hip hop, but the roots of hip hop had been completely forgotten. To where, you know, I could go to, you know, to the south of France or something like that, meet a young beatboxer who loves beatboxing, who's been following beatboxer, but he doesn't know who Razel is, you know, he doesn't know who Dougie Fresh is. Mm-hmm. And so at that point, you know, I really wanted to focus on getting this film completed, because I felt that there was a mission to make sure that it didn't forget its hip hop roots. And plus, the other thing is that America was really dissed as when it comes to beatboxing skills, I say, for the past maybe 5 years or so. And it was really important to me that people knew that this art form was really alive and well here. And right now we've got a resurgence of it, to where now this next generation, you know, just kind of slaughtering people, you know. We were number two this past year at the World Championships in Berlin. The American champion, his name's Napalm, took second place this past year. It's a really, you know, it's a really big thing in our community.
Wow. Wow, this is, we're not going to take any breaks on this interview, because right now you're dropping knowledge on the culture of hip-hop, you know, the form, where it started, where it began. And you even said something about William Morris Agency. Like, they have, you said, a beatboxer. That
yeah, they signed. Have a beatboxer. Yeah, his name is Beardy Man. And
Beardy Man?
Beardy Man. He's from the UK.
Okay.
And then he got he beatboxes. He was like the 2-time UK champion, and then he started to loop his beatboxing and then put effects with it, to where now he's like a vocal DJ. He samples his voice, loops his voice, and then he'll put some sense with it, and he like does major concerts, like headlines Electric Zoo, the big electronic festival here, and just, you know, he's over there, he's a star. And then you have people over here that are using beatboxing in different ways. You know, someone like a Reggie Watts uses beatboxing and layers it. You know, brother from Brooklyn, and you know, he just had that Super Bowl commercial where he's, you know, so you see beatboxing sliding into, you know, more mainstream things in little pockets, but it's always been there. I mean, Queen Latifah started as a beatboxer.
Yeah, we have a call. Go ahead.
Hey, what's up, fellas? Yo, this Buck coming in from Jersey.
Yo,
what's up, Buck?
Yo, what's up, Buck?
What's going on, sir? Yo, the movies are mean. Yo, it's a beast, man. Just want to call in and let everybody know that. The joint is serious.
Okay, cool. I'll definitely go check it out.
Yeah.
I'll definitely go check it out. All right, thanks for calling in, brother. Hello?
But.
All right, cool. All right. Good. So, yeah, go ahead. Finish what you're saying.
The film really tries to touch a bit on the history, but since there had been documentaries that had kind of tried to tackle that, what we wanted to do was really focus on the next generation and to explore the community of what drives this passion and what the applications of it could be. So you'll see in the movie, you can, if you have Time Warner Cable, I believe it's on demand. But you could see in the movie, you know, we go to blind schools in the Bronx at the Lavelle School for the Blind. Me and Taylor McFerrin, Adam Mata, Taylor McFerrin being Bobby's son, you know, had started a program up there with a guy named James Kim, who was, he wanted to kind of give back to the community. So he called us up and asked us if we would want to teach beatboxing, and I had never really thought about that. At the school in the Bronx, and over on Gun Hill Road, there's a school called the Lavelle School for the Blind.
Yeah, one second. I think that called us back. Go ahead.
Yo, Buck.
Hey, yo, I'm back on the line. Back on the line. Yo, I dropped out somehow.
Okay.
Word.
All right. So you saw the film, huh?
He wanted to produce
it. Oh,
yeah. That's why I'm saying it's fam.
Caught in that traffic. In that traffic, huh?
Oh, all right. So you wanted to produce this for the film?
I'm making my way down right now.
Okay. Oh, you're coming down to the studio?
Yes, sir. Yes, awesome, man. You know what I mean?
Word.
You know, just want to, I mean, big up. You know, the film is fire. Let everybody know. Yo, go see that joint when you get a chance.
Yeah, I'm going to definitely check it out, man. Yeah. For real. I'm glad y'all came in today. For real.
Yeah, man, you definitely will enjoy it, yo. You'll definitely enjoy that joint.
Awesome. All right, we're going to let him get back to his interview. We'll see you in a little bit, okay?
All right, so I'll see you soon. All right, fellas, y'all see y'all in a minute.
See you in a minute.
All right. Awesome. Yeah, man, right. And you know, it's something, man, because if they hadn't come on board, man, like, this film would have never got done.
Wow.
You know?
What part does he play in the film?
You know, they came in, you know, when we showed them a rough cut, you know, of what we had put together, because, I mean, it was really, I think we had $800 to shoot it.
Wow.
You know? And that was getting a hold of HD before people, you know, this is 2010, so people did not really have HD.
Yeah.
And so it was quite a task to put the film together, and they came in like the home stretch to helped us to finish it, to really polish it, to make it, you know, acceptable to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
You know, it wouldn't have been possible without them.
How was that process? Like, did you guys travel around the country, or what'd you do?
We didn't really have to travel too much because the event that we did was primarily shot in Brooklyn. A couple of scenes were shot in the Bronx, but we shot it in Brooklyn because it was a part of the international convention, beatboxing convention.
Okay.
And so we had beatboxers from all over the world coming to Brooklyn. So it was really nice because we could be in Gowanus and the neighborhood was just perfect. You know, we had great weather and it just, we were, you know, Manavaskar, the director, was really brilliant at framing the shot. So you can't really tell, it's always moving. So you can't really tell that you're in one neighborhood the whole time. But yeah, like I was saying, you know, beatboxing has always really been a part of popular culture without people really knowing and I guess really respecting it as an art form. It was kind of something that just seemed really quick and amusing to people for a minute, and then, you know, our brains, we just keep it moving, you know. But when you go back and take a glance at the history of what we call beatboxing, I can go from Michael Jackson composing a lot of his songs beatboxing. You know, like he had some tracks that where he would be laying down the drums, you know, vocally, and then they would go and they would master it. I remember seeing a video, and this is just nitpicking on things, but I was a big fan of the Ghetto Boys, of Scarface.
Mm-hmm.
And so I remember seeing like a video of Scarface. I think he was at a strip club, and he was doing one of his numbers, and he was like beatboxing in between. So it was just as Rozelle used to tell me, there was just a time where everybody was beatboxing.
Yeah.
You know, everybody loved the idea of making beats and sounds with your mouths, because we came from a place where we didn't have anything.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we didn't have drum machines and drums, and, you know, we had buckets and our mouths, you know, washing machines, desks, you know, whatever we could create with. And I think what hip hop did was really created a form to drive that passion, to refine that, and to create something that today is extraordinary.
Mm-hmm.
And so part of this is, this film is about telling the story of this community and hopefully giving people a glimpse into what it is and what it can do. There are a lot of applications for it. When we went to Harvard last year, we had like a workshop, and, you know, it was crazy. I never thought that beatboxing would take me to Harvard, you know.
Wow.
But they have the hip hop archive there, and I was sitting in this room with these kids and really going into what beatboxing is today, you know. Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. That's deep. That's deep. So when did the film come out?
The film came out now in 2013. Okay. Was our premiere. We premiered at the Schomburg. Shout out to Martha Diaz. And Harlem has been really great for us because we've screened there a number of times. We were in the People's Film Festival and in the Harlem International Film Festival. The People's Film Festival was really the first one to put us on the map in terms of festivals. Gave us an Audience Choice Award. And the Schomburg just really hosted a beautiful opening night for us. And it was from that moment, I think there were some reps from Urban World there that were at the initial the premiere. Mm-hmm. And we got into Urban World, and then that's when we hooked up with Revolt. Angela Northington, who I don't think she's at Revolt TV anymore, but she was their head of buying, licensing, and acquisitions. And so we had talked for a number of months as we, you know, rushed to finish everything up and really get it ready. And then we had our premiere on TV. So we went from, you know, we went from the world premiere at the Schomburg to being on cable television, you know, nationally in a year. You know, for an independent film,
that's great. Yeah,
you know, that's almost unheard of. You know,
wow. So we can view this film on to Time Warner Cable. What
Time Warner Cable? Well, I'm not sure because I live in Brooklyn. So
is it on demand or?
It's on demand. Yeah, okay. It's on demand, and it's on Revolt TV, which I think if you have a certain package, like if you have like
MTV, yeah,
yeah, if you have Revolt TV, it plays on Revolt TV. It'll be on Revolt TV. For like another year or so. Okay. And they have it on demand there, so you can check it out. And you know, I think it's a great music documentary. You know, it's independent, and it crosses the lines of a documentary and a sporting event, because you're like rooting for who you want to win. Mm-hmm. And I think it's a great introduction for people. It's a great introduction for people who want to come to the American Beatbox Championships now, mm-hmm. Which is happening at Santos Party House, October 25th, which is a Sunday.
Okay. We have a caller. Go ahead.
I'm not letting you up.
Caller, go ahead.
Yes, hi. This is Hashan.
Yo, Hashan.
I'm doing well. I was just calling to say hello to the team.
Yo, what's up?
How's it going, Sean?
Of course, you know, just wishing continued, you know, success on the movie. And, of course, just being, you know, just happy to be part of the team is always a good thing as well. So, yeah. Again, just wanted to say congratulations to you guys for
Thank
your success.
You know, Hushan, the whole team, man, it's, like I said, this would not be possible if, you know, if these brothers had not come to the table, you know, to help us finish this film, to help us get this film out there, it would have failed, you know. And so, you know, there was definitely a time where I think some of us didn't know whether or not this was going to get done, and they believed in it before anybody believed in it, you know. They believed that it was important to tell this story. Because there was, I think, a long time, you know, people really, I guess, because they hadn't seen beatboxing on a super high level outside of maybe seeing Razel or Dougie Fresh live, but hadn't seen where the art had evolved to, and what those you know, pioneers had built. Then they didn't really classify it as an art form, you know, and so it kind of became a subset of MCing. It really wasn't its own element. Mm-hmm. But I think now that's changing and transforming. I mean, you have sometimes you can see beatboxing contributing to the world of acapella. So you have a lot of vocal percussionists who are like working musicians, people who just make beats with their mouths. Mm-hmm. That movie Pitch Perfect became the biggest music film ever. Like, they grossed something like $300 million.
Yeah.
You know? Right. So I think there's an interest to people outside of just the wow factor of somebody beatboxing. I think there's an interest that, you know, when you hear just the human voice and you can be inspired by the human voice, like the brothers you had here before, you know, how they inspire people to take care of their bodies, to love their, you know, to do good to yourself, you know, so that you can build yourself, strengthen yourself. I think the same is true with arts, you know, not just beatboxing, but just the creative in general, you know, to strengthen one's imagination, I believe makes them stronger people.
So are you touring around, like, looking for beatboxers, like, during this film, or how is it set up?
Well, what happened with beatboxing, which I think is what happened with most art forms, the internet brought everyone together. So the internet made the world tiny. And so anyone who was interested in beatboxing could go to humanbeatbox.com or beatboxing.com. And, you know, I was a part of that community back in 2003, 2004, and so we could see the community build, and as YouTube blew up, you know, beatboxers were able to talk to each other, know each other, see each other, exchange techniques, and so we really didn't have to go out and search for them. They came for us because they were looking for a platform. They were looking for a place to be able to expose their talents and to be able to really join with other people who had that interest. Mm-hmm. So they all came to New York. We had beatboxers from Alaska to Hawaii. Mm-hmm. You know.
You want him to come in? Is he part of
it? No.
Okay. All right. Cool.
Yeah. And so we didn't really have to travel too much. We did get to travel with the film festivals. I was able to travel as a beatboxer. I mean, beatboxing was the first thing that took me abroad back in 2006, into 2005. I was invited out to Europe to do an MTV Unplugged and to feature there. And so that was my first touring experience as a beatboxer. And then I just started, you know, step by step, moment by moment, building my own career as a beatboxer. I hooked up with the B-Kangs, which is part of the first black-owned electronics company that made a beat machine, where I worked with them in developing sounds. I did mostly all the beatboxing for that machine. Nice. And so by that point, I had really kind of established myself as a beatboxer. And then I said, you know, my wife at the time, my ex, was like, you know, you should try to organize these events and organize these kids here.
Yeah, we have a call. Sorry.
Yeah.
Caller Gat. Caller. Okay.
And we lost him.
All right, cool. Yeah,
go ahead. Yeah, so I had resisted it for a while because I didn't know how I felt about battling because I guess I, you know, it's like mid-2000s, you know, and I had seen a bit of the battling scene culture wasn't necessarily something I was interested in, like where I think at some moment it had become toxic and less about skills and more about bravado, you know? And then, I mean, that's obviously changed to a certain degree, you know, I think. But once I started the event, it just kind of, you know, took on a life of its own. Jay Roby, actually, from Tribe, was one of the first people to really get on board. He was one of the judges for the first event. He's in the film. Razelle's in the film. Parrish Smith's in the film. And John Legend's music director is in the film. It was nice, man, that the community began to really coalesce and make a classic, you know, classic documentary. But you know, that was 2010. You know, today, you know, 2015, the competition level is crazy.
Rose, yeah.
It's a completely different, you know, sphere now. Mm-hmm. So when if you come down to the American Beatbox Championships, which happens to be next month.
Where's it at?
It's at Santos Party House. Santos Party House is, I believe it's like Midtown.
Oh, it's in Manhattan.
Yeah, it's in Manhattan.
New York, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. I mean, it's a nice club, you know.
Wow. Is that like on a weekend or?
It's a Sunday. It's Sunday? A Sunday. It's an early Sunday night, you know.
Might try to check
and,
it out.
And yeah, man, what I can do is I can hook up some, you know, some tickets for you to give away or something like that.
Nice.
Or okay. Some discounts, you know what I'm saying?
Okay. Okay. Say that again. Okay. All right.
Okay. So yeah, man. I mean, I'm really honored to be here, you know, to tell people about the film and about our community, because I think when people really begin to see the history and see what this is about, they'll be surprised that, you know, this little forgotten, you know, element, you know, that your cousin used to do, you know, annoying you or something, mm-hmm. you know, ended up kind of reemerging from the underground. And, you know, one of the things that I do wish, and I know it's happening now, you know, I wish that there was more engagement, you know, because I work in a lot of schools mm-hmm. and, you know, throughout New York City, throughout Brooklyn specifically. And, you know, there a lot of our young brothers, you know, they don't really get the history of hip hop. Mm-hmm. They don't, it's not presented to them, mm-hmm. you know? So they're, where it felt like, I don't know, maybe it's just me, but it felt like there was this transformation where for a lot of kids, hip hop became something that you viewed, you were a spectator. Whereas when we were coming up, I believe it was just something you lived.
Yeah.
You know? So everybody was trying to write rhymes. Everybody was trying to beatbox. Everybody was trying to dance. And it became a way of play and a way to actually nurture our imagination in a world that was trying to strangle that, mm-hmm. you know?
Yeah. Wow. So let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
Like, do you ever hold, like, some type of platform or forum where, like, you discuss with large groups of people about, like, the history of hip-hop and things like that?
I mean, I'd like to. I mean, sometimes I go into interviews and you know, we wind up talking about it. And you know, at Harvard at the Hip Hop Archive, we were discussing that. Mm. And I think there are some forums where that needs to take place and does take place, because I feel like if our kids knew, you know, they would have a different image of themselves.
Respect,
you know, a different respect of themselves, you know, because, you know, it's like I was in Bhutan, which is like between Nepal and India this past February, mm-hmm. right? This small little country that just started letting people come in.
Wow.
You know, and I'm listening to, like, these are people that are just now getting musical instruments and shit. Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm. They're playing the music that we grew up on. They're playing the 50s, the 60s, the soul music. They're playing the old hip hop, mm-hmm. you know, in this country, you know, that didn't even have internet a few years ago, mm-hmm. you know,
wow.
and they're being inspired by all of the things that our culture created, mm-hmm. you know, even if they listen to Elvis.
Okay.
Right. So, but I feel like sometimes I think there's a hunger for our kids to want to know that, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. you know, there's a hunger for our kids to want to know that, mm-hmm. but there needs to be more of a concerted effort in the platforms. And there are some organizations that are doing that by creating hip hop classes, hip hop theater. Mm-hmm. But I don't think that it should be something that is just an elective, like something that this is after school, mm-hmm. you know. So these brothers, I know that this one program, I think RZA's a part of it, I found out about it when I was up at Harvard. What they're doing is like they're taking these skills, because you know you have some of these kids that are in there, you know, in school rhyming, they can write rhymes, they can recite any rhyme by, you know, I don't know, anybody, Wiz Khalifa, you know. But if they could take that same skill and apply it to science, mm-hmm. if they could take that same skill and apply it to another subject, then we could have young brothers doing like what these brothers that I was working with did, starting their own black-owned electronics company.
Okay. All right. Well, we gotta wrap it up.
Yeah. Yeah.
We're gonna have to have you come back.
This is a great interview. Yeah. You definitely gotta come back.
I'd love to come back.
Sitting here listening.
Yeah, we rolled out without no breaks. So catch us again next week, 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. Big Picture Radio Show.
BigPictureRadio.com.
Check us out. Go to the website. You can watch this whole show. You're schooled on the American Beatbox documentary.
AmericanBeatboxer.com. Mm-hmm. AmericanBeatbox.com.
All right. Nice. So tune in next week. We'll be here. All right. Big Picture. Holla back.
See you later.